this flash drum. In actual, when in any EPC company or any licensing company, when we are sizing this two-phase separator or three-phase separator, there is always some pressure drop at the feed nozzle. And next, if there is any demister pad at the top, there will be some pressure drop at the top. So here you can see that whatever pressure is of stream number 3, same pressure is of stream 4, and same pressure is of stream number 5. But in actual, this is not the case. There will always be some pressure drop at the feed nozzle itself. Based on that pressure drop, if it is any demister pad, then we will have to account that pressure drop of the demister pad also. Else, the pressure will be whatever pressure after feed nozzle, whatever will be the resulting pressure, that pressure will be of stream number 4 and stream number 5. See, here we were discussing about, this is our feed stream that is entering into this flash drum. The moment the feed will enter into the column, into the drum, the feed nozzle itself, there across the nozzle, there will be some pressure drop. Let's say your feed stream is, for example, let's say it is of at 100 kPa, and the moment it enters into this vessel, there will be some pressure drop at the feed nozzle. Let's say it's 10 kPa. So result, what will be the resulting pressure? 100 kPa of stream and 10 delta P of nozzle, feed nozzle is 10 kPa. So resulting pressure will be 90 kPa. So 90 kPa will be the pressure at the bottom and 90 kPa will be the pressure at the top, provided there is no demister pad. But if you have the demister pad also, so since your resulting pressure here is 90 kPa, and whatever is the delta P across this demister pad, that you will also take into the account. So let's say again it is also 10 kPa. So ultimate pressure of this stream number 4 will be 100 minus 10 minus 10, that is 80. But at the bottom it will be 100 minus 10, that is 90 only. So this is the only difference. In a normal days, whenever we are working in any EPC company, just we are not taking into account all those things. We are just taking, because in an EPC company or any licensing company, the ultimate objective of this using the flash drum is just to know how much vapor is there and how much liquid is there and what are its their properties. The remaining portion, that is sizing and delta P across the nozzle, delta P across the demister, they are not considering all those things here in the simulation because they already have their own template for sizing. Whether it is two-phase separator sizing or three-phase separator sizing, they are already having their own template, or you can say sizing template they are using. So they are not using this detail. They are not using this detail. That is the only reason. But yes, you can do all those things here also. Let us repeat once again. Whenever we are working in any EPC company or in any licensing company, the use of this separator is just to separate the vapor and liquid. That you can also do by using some manual calculation by using this stream number 3. You see that stream number 3 is having 70% vapor and remaining is liquid. Yes, by doing some manual calculation also, 70% of this will be the vapor, that is this much, and 30% of this will be the liquid, that is this much. Even though you can do by manual calculation, but after that you need properties of this stream. That is very tedious task to estimate the properties. That is why we are using always simulations. So now, based on this given condition, you have separated the steam number 3 into vapor and liquid, that is steam number 4 and 5. This is the only task we are supposed to do in most of the cases. Next, here you will find that energy. Maybe if you are working in any EPC project or any industrial project, you may come across a case in which you will find that there is some heating arrangement inside this particular vessel. There is some heating arrangement inside this particular vessel. Then how much heat duty is being provided to this vessel that you can provide here? Again, it is very rare case that you are going to simulate this thing, but I am telling you the why it has been given in the HYSYS, and HYSYS can be used for all those applications. In practical, we have come across in many cases like storage of some highly viscous fluid. Those who are working on some live project, they must be knowing that we used to provide the steam tracing to the line, and this steam tracing is required because if your plant is at a certain location where temperature goes to certain level, means the freezing point, if the temperature goes below or up to the freezing temperature of that particular fluid, in that case flow will not occur. So to prevent those freezing, we used to provide the steam tracing. Again, tracing may be of steam tracing or electrical tracing. That depends upon the case to case. That is separate thing. Now, apart from providing the steam tracing, you may require to provide some heating coil inside that tank from which you are circulating that particular or that highly viscous fluid. You may be required to provide them some electrical heating equipment or sometimes any heat exchanger, steam coil. Any kind of arrangement can be provided. That depends upon the application to application. So that case also you can simulate in the HYSYS. Here you will provide the energy stream and see how much energy we need to provide to keep this fluid into the liquid phase. It should not freeze. Next is parameter type. As we were discussing in the beginning, that delta P at the feed nozzle itself, there will be some pressure drop in actual, but here we have not taken into account any delta P at the feed nozzle, and we have not taken into account any delta P across this demonstrator pad. This flash drum, or you can say two phase separator part, and here now this is the generic flash drum. If you see that the type is given here as separator, you can convert this into the three phase separator also by clicking over here. You can convert this into the tank also by clicking over here. But again, since we already have the template available, if such kind of case comes, then what we are doing, we are just taking the separate drum and not using that options. Let's see. If you want to convert this vertical separator into a three phase separator, you can convert it by using this button itself. Here, see, it has been converted into the vapor and three phase separator. Since, because it has not converged, reason, this is the three phase separator, it needs one more stream for its convergence. That's why it is red. So these are the features available inside this particular template. Now, so when you may come across about sometimes that if any flow sheet is given to you, you may find that this exchanger is looking like this, and if you want to convert this into some different form, then you can change its icon also. Like you can make it like this, it will look like this. And these are basically the features that you can utilize by practicing. That is up to you. Whatever you want, you can do. It's just like a cosmetic change to look your flow sheet beautiful. You can do all those things like this. Also, you can change this icon here. If you want, we can change it like this. Now it is the feed nozzle, this is demonstrator pad. All those things you can do by using this feature of HiSys. Anybody have any question in this fresh drum?
Tank also separate something, the tank that will be used, or that will be just used as a storage tank.
Can you please your headphones closer to your mouse? Your voice is very blurred.
What I mean to ask is, the tank that is available in the separator option, is it used for storage purpose, or is it also used for separating purpose?
No, that is basically used for the if you want to separate the tank form and all those things, then you can use that things. Then you can use. See the reason what is happening inside the tank and what is happening inside this flash drum. Inside the flash drum, basically based on the vapor fraction available, you are basically separating the vapor and liquid phase inside the flash drum. But in case of the tank, your objective is to store the liquid. In that case, you will try to prevent the vapor losses from the tank. Your objective will not be to separate the vapor and liquid, because in the tank you will be storing the liquid only. In one case, that is, I'm talking about the I'm not talking about any LPG and all those special kind of things. In that case, there is some separate kind of arrangement. But in normal practice, the tank which is available here and the tank which you used to see in the plant or refinery, any refinery, the objective of this tank is to store the either raw material or some intermediate product or finished product in the form of the liquid. And if it is stored in the form of the liquid, then whatever in the form of vapor, whatever is passing, that is ultimately your loss. So again, here the tank will be used only for the storage purpose only. But again, after that, if you go to the practical scenario in the plant which is having this kind of storage facility, you may be sometimes storing any toxic material inside this tank. You may be storing some hydrocarbon inside this tank. So based on the materials stored inside this tank, you may have some inert. You may have to create some inert atmosphere just above the liquid phase. See, if you have any storage tank which is storing liquid, then ultimately what will be the in its vapor section, what will be there? there will be some vapors of that particular hydrocarbon. Right?
Yes, sir.
There only vapor that will be there. But if it is hydrocarbon, we always try to keep it. We always try to isolate it from the ambient, because hydrocarbon vapor, when it will come into the contact with the atmospheric oxygen, it will form the explosive mixture and some kind of emergency. Now you can imagine that hydrocarbon and oxygen will form, then any unfortunate things may happen, like a fire or anything can happen. So in that case, what we are doing is, in the tank, what we are doing is we are storing the hydrocarbon in the liquid phase, and apart from that, the vent line, even though the vent line will be there, that vent line is connected to the nitrogen by using the split range controller that we are doing. In that case, when we are using a split range controller to control the pressure inside the tank. So when the pressure inside that tank is reducing, means, let's say you are transferring the material from the tank to somewhere. So you are removing the liquid from the tank. So to fill up that vacant space created, removed vacant space by the liquid, that vacant space should be filled with either air or anything. But we are not allowing the air to enter inside this tank. So for that case, we are using the nitrogen to come inside this tank. And when we are receiving the material inside the tank, the liquid level will go up. And so whatever the inert atmosphere is available just above the liquid phase, that should be again removed from the tank. So that will be purged out from the tank. So that kind of arrangement we are using in practical scenario. That is, we call it the use the split range controller. When pressure inside the tank goes below, it will allow the nitrogen to come inside the tank. Now when pressure inside the tank increases, then it will close the nitrogen inlet valve and it will open the nitrogen outlet valve. So whatever the pressure has been increased, that will be relieved by using the split range outlet controller. That kind of arrangement we are using. Yes, the storage tank here, that will be just for the storage purpose, that we will be using in high season. The remaining thing which we are discussing, like split range controller and all those things, that is again comes into the after the simulation. The next activity which we are doing in the licensing company or in the EPC company, that is the next activity, that whether we should provide the split range controller or what kind of arrangement we can do, whether we should use the fixed roof tank or floating roof tank, whether we should use the spherical tank. All those things come at later stage.
Okay, sir.
So see, whenever we are working in any project, project phases are of so many types. One thing is, if the process does not exist, based on the, you have developed any new process whose even flow sheet is not available in any encyclopedia, even no flow sheet is available, let's say, and based on your research, you have developed some process. So since you have developed some process, so you will be knowing each and everything about that process, whether the feed will be in liquid phase or it will be in vapor liquid phase. or totally it will be in vapor phase. So based on that information available with you, that information you will be using to simulate your entire plant in Hi-Sync or any simulator tool based on the information available with you. Again, once you have simulated all those things, now you know what is my objective, what is my process, what is my raw material, and based on this reaction and this separation, this will be my product. Now your objective has been achieved on paper. Now you are simulating it on the any simulator. In the simulation, also you have achieved your target. From this raw material, you are able to achieve this and this product. This is one phase. Now, next it will go for the scale up. You can say scale up. Because whatever new process, new development you have done, definitely that will be that you have done on your inside your laboratory. So that laboratory scale process go for the scale up from laboratory to the pilot plant. Then from the pilot plant it will go for the industrial scale. So even though inside chemistry and everything will be the same, the only difference will be in your pilot plant you are using 2-inch pipeline for your feed steam, and for your industrial scale, based on the capacity for which you are going to design your industrial plant, this 2-inch line may become 20-inch line. And depending upon the scale up, there will be some limitation that here you will not be able to use the heat 72 type of exchanger. You will not be able to use plate type exchanger. Each and everything you will be doing in the engineering phase, subsequent phase. Okay. So next. So next we will discuss about conversion reactor simulation. Based on the developed process, your simulation is one part. And the secondary is your after the simulation, the things goes for the in engineering phase. Then there are so many things you are supposed to do in basic engineering, like in licensing company, we are bound to do some certain kind of activity. Basically, if I'm working for the licensing company, our main focus will be our process guarantee. Like, if by using this process, if you are using this raw material, I take that guarantee that you will be able to achieve this much of product with this much of purity. Licensors take the guarantee. And based on this, he has done some preliminary sizing, like exchanger pressure drop should be this much, my distillation column tray will be this much, my column top pressure will be this much, my column bottom pressure will be this much. So all these things are fixed up by the licensor. Next thing is, like EPC company, they will again go through the, they will basically touch upon the hydraulic calculation, pump, and they will try to means economize the process. Like if the licensor has given the 8-inch size based on the certain flow, if they will find that no, instead of 8-inch line, 6-inch line is sufficient, then they will discuss with licensor and all those things. So there are some limitation to the licensor. The licensor in for any project, licensing company is developing the PD process design package, PDP, or sometimes we used to call it as the basic design package. In 3 to 4 months only, in 3 to 4 months, we as a licensor do the simulation and generate the heat and material balance, generate the steam summary, then the preliminary calculation, and finally develop the process data sheet of each and every equipment, then combine all those things and hand over this entire process design package to the client. Now, this duration will be only maximum 3 to 4 months. Now, whatever licensor has done in 3 to 4 months of time for any PDP, any process design package, this work when go to the any EPC company, it will be the activity which they will be performing for all those things, it will take at least for 1.5 to 2 years. So licensor is having certain, means you can say that each and everybody's scope has been defined. If licensor is developing a project, then this activity will be done by the licensor and the remaining will be done by the DEC. This kind of basically work distribution is there. Again, the reactor, part, the column part, whatever licensor has finalized, any EPC company will not touch that. They will just, we as a licensor tell them that this is my feed and my feed will enter into the column at, let's say, 15th tray at this condition. And my column top pressure should be this much, column bottom pressure should be this much, condenser duty should be this much, the boiler duty should be this much. This thing, this should not be affected by using, you do activity at your own, but these parameters should not be affected at any cost. If this will be affected by your mistake, then we will not take the guarantee. So these kind of stand we as a licensors are taking. So whether it is reactor or any column, any compressor, so these all are the critical items. So EPC company does not touch these unit operations. Even in India, all the licensor companies which are available here, the main critical part like reactor, their head office is doing, and they are finalizing all those things. In India, people are not doing those things. So just for our learning purpose, we should know what are the various reactors available inside the simulation and how we can simulate those reactors. See, the reactors which are available in the HYSYS are basically conversion reactor, equilibrium reactor, and CSTR reactor, plug flow reactor. These kind of reactors are available in the HYSYS. But in most of the cases, the reactor parameter, basically the licensor share only few documents to the EPC company. There are so many things which are proprietary, which licensors are not sharing with any DEC company or any client company. Basically, all those are their proprietary things. So while doing the reactor simulation, whatever the information is available with us, basically for the conversion reactor, how much conversion will be there, what is the reaction that is happening, and what are the products that will be formed by using this reaction. So this is the only objective for doing the reactor simulation. So at least we should know how, if we come across how to simulate the reactor, at least we should know how we should proceed with the reactor simulation and what are the various input that we should know before proceeding for the reactor simulation. Again, in India, if you are working for any company, you will not be doing. Either you are doing some research work, then only you will be doing all these things. Otherwise, distillation column, reactors, you never come across to do the rigorous simulation of any reactor or rigorous simulation of any column. Unless you have some own interest to go through the details of the reactor or any column. So the case which we are going to take is basically the fuel cell energy conversion device, in which methane is converting to the CO and CO2. The reaction is given as methane plus oxygen, which is converted into the carbon monoxide and hydrogen. The conversion percent 0 plus C1 plus C2 T square is again this. These all are the parameters that we should know for this. If you know all these parameters, then you will be able to simulate the reactors. Like if you are going to convert methane is converting into the CO and CO2, then what will be the conversion percent, what will be the value of the C0 or C1 or C2, and at what temperature, these information, as I said in the beginning, that reactor part is the licensor is taking the entire guarantee of the process, and they never used to share their confidential information. So all these information which are available in the literature or any book that we have captured, like methane will be converted to the CO and CO2. Based on that, C0 is 40 and CO conversion, and C0 is 60 for the CO2 conversion. These are the input that we are having. Based on this information, we will develop a model to represent the partial oxidation of methane and to produce the hydrogen. So if we have the methane oxygen, how we can convert, how we can partially do the oxidation of methane to produce the hydrogen by using the any simulator. Now, I'm not talking about the HYSYS. You can use any simulator to produce the hydrogen by using methane and oxygen. So as we know, before proceeding for the simulation, what we have to do is we have to enter the composition. Here the composition will be methane, oxygen, CO, and a hydrogen. Methane, oxygen is there, then CO2. So ultimately there will be these methane, oxygen, CO, and CO2. Now, here we have entered the nitrogen also, because here we are using the ambient air for oxygen. That is why we are taking into consideration nitrogen also. If we have the pure oxygen, then there is no need to take the nitrogen inside the composition. Let us go to the HYSYS. Yes. Now, first we will enter the component like methane. Then oxygen, nitrogen, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen. Next, we will use the Penck problem for equation of state. Now we have entered into the simulation environment. We have entered the component, we have selected the thermodynamic package, then we have entered here. Now, we will go to the reaction tab. Now we will go to the reaction tab and add the reaction. See, here in once you have what we have done till now, our objective is to generate the hydrogen by using methane. Here in this exercise, our objective is to generate the hydrogen by using the methane gas with it, by reacting with atmospheric air. So methane will react with oxygen, it will convert to the carbon dioxide and hydrogen, as well as carbon monoxide and hydrogen. So since we have taken the oxygen from the air, so what we have done, we have taken the methane, CO, CO2, then nitrogen as the composition. Then we have entered, we have selected the thermodynamic package, that is Penck-Robinson. Up to this, things are common, but here we are going to simulate the reactor. So here we have gone through the reaction tab, and here we will enter the reaction set. Then again we will come back to the simulation environment, then take the stream and define those stream, then take the reactor and all those things. Less than 1 minute. Okay, let's disconnect again once more. Only 1 minute is remaining, so I'm going to disconnect it and reconnect it.